Parkinson's disease affects the body from a number of different levels. We could look at the clinical signs, or we can look at what a person actually feels associated with the clinical signs.
We have four cardinal signs that we look for. First being the recognizable tremor that we see in the hands and the jaw. We also see more rigidity and tension in the muscle tone as well, making it harder for people to move appropriately. We also see a slowing of gait, we call this bradykinesia. And lastly, this loss of postural instability, which makes older people with Parkinson's at higher risk for falling.
From an individual perspective, they gain a self-perception of being different. And that in the utmost is of importance for us in our research so that we can really learn to identify the changes that are occurring within Parkinson's disease that aren't associated with the disease itself, but influence the person that is dealing with the disease.
This study was part of a larger study that we were doing on Parkinson's patients and to look and assess muscle quality within the population.
This study is trying to understand how you can determine a decline in functional ability in Parkinson's disease that can be easily understood. We looked at gait, balance, and posture, as well as hand grip.
Our hypothesis had suggested that we were going to find changes in mobility and balance would be most appropriate for this population, and it wasn't. It was grip strength came out to be the most strongly associated with changes in muscle activity.
And that's really telling because one simple test from a hand grip dynamometer, which is really quick and can be easily undertaken by both physicians as well as community therapists, tells us a lot about the physiological decline. And for me, that's important because physiological decline precedes functional decline.
For persons who are suffering from Parkinson's disease and those who are caring for them, the use of using a grip strength test will allow us to make more quality assessments in terms of their physiological capacity. And as that grip strength becomes the decline, then obviously interventions that would try to improve strength would then allow the person to maintain a higher quality of life regardless of the progression of the disease.